Hey, I have a new drone here, the Happymodel Crux3 NLR, and I'm guessing the LR stands for long range. It's a small drone driven by a 1S battery, an 1800-650 battery, which means that you shouldn't expect that much out of it because these kind of batteries don't have a lot of power. It's not allowing you to do a lot of tricks and stuff like that. But let's see. If you ask me why I'm reviewing this drone or why I'm interested in this drone, I really have to say that I'm not so sure. I got it, I thought it was interesting, and I decided to check it out. Okay, let's see what's in the box then. Here we have some extra props, tools, screwdrivers, extra screws, and this prop tool that never works. We also have this remote control for the camera that you can use to adjust some parameters inside. It's a Cadex camera. We have the drone itself. Look how nicely packed the props are on, which is not really normal, but it fits here well. The drone has a GPS included. It has Express ELRS with the ceramic antenna. We have the place for the 18650. Small. It looks quite fragile, so you don't want to crash this thing. We have some stickers. And then a manual, and very important, the direction of the battery, how you have to feed it. The original concept, the one created by Dave C, it's today produced by a company called HGLRC, and it's called the Recon 3. This one is the Happymodel Crux3 NLR, and the main difference, and something that attracted me and make me think about this one and not the HGLRC, is that this one can come, you can select it with the GPS. For me, when you are talking about a drone that is going to fly away, long range or not, we can discuss that or we can argue if this drone is long range or not. But anyway, if you're thinking that this drone is gonna go more than 500 meters away, I wanna have a GPS in case that something happens, I lose it, or I need help to find it. This drone also has a beeper, which is another thing that I think is important for a drone that you're flying long. If you lose it, if it landed wherever you didn't expect to land, you want to have something that tells you where the drone is so you can search for it and find it. So this drone checked those two boxes, GPS, beeper. The beeper is not super loud, but at least it has a beeper and it's not just the motors trying to do some sound. This drone has also a 200 milliwatts VTX, which doesn't sound too much to be a long range, but let's see how it acts in this case. When I got the drone, I thought about three things that I wanted to test. The first one, it's how it flies and how it reacts when the weather is a little bit bad and you have a lot of wind or any amount of wind. The second one is, now I have a GPS in this kind of drone, and I want to make sure that the GPS can help me with GPS rescue in case that I lose connectivity with the drone. The third test is about how much time I can fly. Again, it's a 1S battery. I'm getting the best quality battery that is possible, and I want to see how many minutes this drone can actually fly. So how does this drone fly? When I took it out the first time and I start flying, the first thing that I saw was that the thing was shaking like hell. And I thought directly, oh, this isn't gonna be a good experience. At the same time, I had a battery warning even though I just charged the battery. So I was thinking, maybe there's something wrong with the battery, or maybe the drone drained the battery very fast. I don't know. The good thing is that I waited some days in order to not get that much wind, and I tried to fly it again, and the experience was different this time. With no wind at all, the drone actually flies smooth, and you can go around and check and cruise without that much problem or without that much shakiness in the camera. The battery thing seems to be also a user problem and not drone related, because I charged them again and I had a couple of them and I could fly without getting the warning, or I went out and I could fly like regularly as expected with the drone. The drone is using one of these batteries, and as I said, you can't expect that much out of it because the way these batteries behave are more to give energy during long time and not give energy in punches. So these kind of batteries are good if you are just flying, like if you're just cruising around and going between trees and these kind of things, but you are not supposed to use these kind of batteries, Liion batteries, when you are wanting to go up and do tricks and flips and that kind of things. But something that I realized directly with my test is that there is no power on this drone to fight wind at all. The second point that I wanted to test is the GPS. There are different kind of GPS in the market for drones, and a lot of concern around how long does the GPS take in order to get satellite lock. You need satellite lock in order to start flying with a reference to home so the drone can come back or can try to do GPS rescue if you want to use it that way. In the case of the GPS that comes with this drone, the first time that I tried to get some satellites, it took me up to 7 minutes, which I thought it was quite a lot of time. The second and the third time, which were very close to the first time, it was much faster, and that's also to expect because the GPS can save some kind of information in order to reduce the time that it takes to get GPS lock. Don't ask me why, but the next time that I tried to fly, and I was expecting it to be again 7-8 minutes, it only took 2 minutes to get GPS lock. The weather was kind of similar, no clouds, no anything, but it took much less time. The next time that I tried to fly, the GPS took again like 7-8 minutes to get lock. So here, the conclusion of the story is that the GPS is not that reliable. I didn't really realize what was the difference between the first try, the second, and the third, but they gave me totally different times from the same place with the same GPS and similar weather. So this GPS is not super extra good quality. That's only a guess. But something that I have to say and to be glad of is that I was flying and in the middle of the fly, I lost connectivity. The GPS rescue started without any problem and took the drone back to the point where I could get back control and land without any problem. That says that the GPS, even if not very reliable when locking the satellites at the beginning, it saved my life or it saved my drone. So it's working, it's well configured out of the box. I didn't do anything else than change the altitude at which the drone will come back if it got into GPS rescue mode. So it works, and that's a good point. I was actually planning to do a controlled test of the GPS rescue, but I guess I got lucky inside my unlock and things happened, GPS worked, and I still have my drone, so that's pretty good. Let's talk about the battery. One of the selling points of this drone is that with one of these batteries, you get around 15 to 20 minutes of flight time. In my tests, I never got over 12 minutes. Sometimes I got 10, sometimes I got 11, and around that number I will say. Which is not bad if you think about it, to fly and cruise and just go around with the drone for 10, 12 minutes, you might even get bored before that time comes. But it's not even close to what marketing is saying about 15 or 20 minutes of flight time. If I had different conditions of what they use to test, most probably yes. As I said, there is a lot of wind around this area, but those days that I went out flying, I chose no wind or I waited for no wind because I know that the drone doesn't fly well under those conditions. One important point to talk about when it comes to the battery and this drone is that this kind of battery, if you look at it, doesn't have any physical difference between the plus and the minus sign, which makes also the fact that the drone itself in the battery tray doesn't have any physical difference between plus and minus. And you can very, very easily insert the battery with the wrong polarity. If you do so, you burn the drone. There is nothing protecting the drone. In another kind of drone, you have the XT30 or XT60, which they fit only in one way, and that kind of physically protect the polarity of the battery when you're connecting to the drone. But in this case, there is nothing protecting you. There is a little TPU mark with a plus sign inside the tray, but beside that, nothing. So be very careful when you get one of these drones. You have to make sure that you are placing the battery with the right polarity, otherwise you burn that FC, and in this case that FC has everything, the receiver, the VTX, the ESC and everything. So you lose kind of the drone completely. If you've been following my channel, you know that I'm a big fan of Express LRS. And one point that I like quite a lot from this drone is that it has Express LRS integrated in the flight controller. That means this flight controller has an SPI based Express LRS receiver, but it was the first time that I got to configure or bind an Express LRS SPI receiver. And it was not straightforward for me. It took some reading and it took some trial and error. Not complicated, but as everything new, it takes a little bit of effort. If you don't know how to do that, I have another video through the whole process that you can use. I'm going to put it on the description of this video so you can check it out if you are thinking to have this drone or any other drone that has Express LRS integrated on the flight controller. So, do I recommend this drone? I have to say like this, if you are looking just to fly around for 10, 12 minutes without having to carry a lot in your suitcase, this drone could be the right drone. It flies okay, smoothly, as long as there is not much wind. It's small and will fit almost anywhere. It uses Liion batteries that sometimes is easier to handle than LiPos. And it's something interesting to have, interesting to test. So you might want to have one, fly around, cruise, check out some areas, explore a little bit, and come back home. Why not? For me, it's just cool to know that technology has gotten to a point where in one card, you have Express LRS, you have ESCs, you have flight controller, you have almost everything. You just have to add four motors, one camera and a GPS, and you are good to go and fly. In this small form factor, with only one cell, with only one battery, that is for me amazing. I think that's everything that I have for today. Thank you for watching and hope to see you soon.